Friends, welcome to a brand new lecture on JLPT N5 course. Okay, and today onwards we are starting our actual journey of JLPT learnings. And the way it has been structured is, first there will be a vocabulary list which we call as tango, and then we have some sentence patterns, then a kaiwa conversation. Okay, so let's begin. It will probably scare you, but vocabulary list is the most important thing that you should start building from now onwards. So what will happen is, every chapter, every lecture will have a list of words that you probably need to start mugging up. Once you do start doing that, slowly and gradually you will keep on increasing your vocabulary. Okay, and then sentence patterns, then other stuff. Okay, let's start with the first one. So first one is watashi, I, which means I, myself. Watashi, watashi tachi is what? We. So whenever I'm speaking this language, this word, you please repeat it at your end, so that you start pronouncing the words correctly. Okay? And soon in the live session we will have I'll interact with you and understand that how did you perform and how is pronunciation going. So please start doing that. And also, one of the prerequisites for this lecture is that you should have this hiragana katakana understood, remembered by your brain. So you should have practiced at least 100 times about hiragana katakana, otherwise I'll go on my own pace and you will not be able to catch up. So once you see these words, the hiragana, you should be able to figure out. Okay, so the first word is watashi. Okay, the second word is watashi tachi. What does it mean? It means we. So okay, third word is anata, you. Anohito, okay, that person, the other person in the room. Then comes minasan, all of you, ladies and gentlemen. So minasan is for the complete group of people. So whenever somebody is giving a speech or something and addressing the whole public, they would address it with the word minasan. Ohayo gozaimasu, good morning everyone. I have already talked about this in my first lecture, san. So it is basically a title suffix of Mr., Mrs. or Miss, and it comes at the end of the name, after the name actually. And then comes for chan. Chan is used for basically for kids. Like Sonu chan or something of that sort, it's being used. Okay. Then kun is used for a boy's name. Kun. Jin is used for a nationality of a person. So America Jin, Indo Jin, Chugoku Jin. Chugoku Jin is what? Chinese person. Or Russia Jin. Okay. Beikoku Jin. Beikoku Jin is what? Britain people, UK people. Okay. Now sensei is for what? Sensei. Sensei is for teacher or instructor. So I am your sensei. Okay. So you can call me Bhaskar Sensei. Okay. Next one is Kyoshi. It's used for teacher or an instructor. Okay. Probably confusing a bit more, this one and Kyoshi and Sensei, but generally Sensei is being used. Now Gakse is what? Student. So you are a student. You are a Gakse. Okay. Then company employee is what? Kaisha-in. Kaisha-in. Kai shine. And slowly when you are reading these words, you please try to understand a bit on this kanji also, because sooner or later once you start learning more, you will have to remember this kanjis also. Okay. Moving on, 14th number is Shine. It is also an employee of a company. So there are two ways. Kaishain is something like a salaried worker or a company employee, and Shine is also similar, employee of a company. So it's these are interchangeably used. Ginkgoin is what? Bank employee. Isha is what? Medical doctor. So doctors are called Isha. Gyoin is what? Bank employee. Sorry, Ginkgoin. Okay, Ginkgo is bank, and bank employee is called Ginkgoin. So in is the suffix. Researcher is what? Kenkyusha. Kenkyusha. Engineer. Okay, this is where what katakana has been used for engineer. Okay, university is Daigaku. Hospital is what? Byoin. Byoin. Okay, electricity is Denki. Who? Tare. Ya fir Donata. Tare Donata. Who? Donata is a polite form of Dare. So there is a differentiation between a polite form and a normal form. So polite form is more honorific, or it's being more pleasing to listen to. So it can be interchangeably used, Donata and Dare, but Dare is little bit impolite in Japanese language. Sai is how many years old you are, or Nansai is how old you are. So I am, say, 20 years old. So 20, Niju Sai desu. And if I have to ask how old are you, I will use Nansai desu ka. Okay. Hi. Hi is very simple. Yes. Ie is no. Yes. No. Hi. Ie. Okay. Moving on. Shitsure desu ka. Yes. Excuse me. But so if you have to, confront, or you have to you have a different view, so how to break that conversation is excuse me, but then your sentence comes. The first interest in Japanese probably everybody learns is or everybody would ask you that since you are learning Japanese, okay, tell me how to ask your name. So now you are going to learn that. So onamaewa. Okay, onamaewa. Onamaewa nan desu ka. Actually that's up. Full sentence. O namae wa nan desu ka? So what's your name? So watashi no namae wa so and so desu. Watashi no namae wa Bhaskar desu. Watashi no namae wa Ankush desu. Something like that. Hajimemashite. Hajimemashite is what? When you meet a person for the first time, you say hajimemashite. Okay? Hajimemashite. First time when you meet. First time not in the day, but first time in the whole journey of your life. So That's the protocol for this. And dozo yoroshiku onegashimasu. So this is again a very, very commonly used term. So any work that you give it to anyone, or somebody gives you a work, at the end of the work, or while parting, ending the conversation, they will say dozo yoroshiku onegashimasu. It's like it was pleased to meet you, nice to meet you, and it's a request or a favor they would have asked for, and that's how it is used. Okay. And kuchira wa so and so san desu. So this is for introducing another person. So suppose there are you are introducing a friend of yours to a Japanese colleague, and then what you will say, kuchira wa so and so san desu, kuchira wa Amit san desu, kuchira wa Ankush san desu, something like that. Okay. And if you have to say that, yeah, I came from India, or I came from America, or something of that sort, what you would say? America kara kimashita, Hindu kara kimashita. Okay. So, kara kimashita. Kara is what? From. Kimashita is what? It's a past tense. Past tense of the verb came, come. Okay. I came from so and so country. Now moving on, as I talked about that, sentence patterns we'll be talking about. So today's sentence patterns theme is introduction, basically. Okay. So that's why hajimemashite. So first time when you are meeting someone, how will you interact and talk about that? Okay. So watashi wa Mike Mira desu. So this is the first sentence you can talk about when you are introducing yourself. Okay. Watashi wa Mike Mira desu. Saito san wa Gakse ja arimasen ya gakse deva arimasen. It, what does this sentence means? Saitu-san is not a student. Okay, deva arimasen and ja arimasen. Deva ja arimasen again is much more polite than deva arimasen. Both are in, both are used and both are the correct answers also. So next question sentence is Meera san wa kaisha in desu ka. It's a question, right? Because it has ended with ka. And what is it? Sen is what we taught, we learned in the previous chapter. That sen is a negative sentence. This is an affirmative sentence, correct? So Meera san wa kaisha in desu ka. It's a question. Is Meera san a company employee? Saito-san mo kaisha in this. No, Saito-san mo kaisha in this. Saito-san mo is what? Mo is also. So yes, Saito-san is also a company employee. Okay? Understood till this point? If you haven't understood, pause it. Go back to the previous vocabulary list. Come back to this and put this hand in hand and then start checking whether you have understood or not. Any doubts, any questions, please write out to me in comments. We are going to have a live session and there we'll try to resolve it, and I'll try to make you understand in more detail. Probably that will be a feedback session from that how you have progressed. Okay, now more of sentence examples. Okay, so bonke is sentence pattern. This is pattern. Okay, this is the pattern we taught here, we learned here. Okay, then comes example sentences. Okay, bun re bun. Re is what? Example. This also we learned in the previous chapter. Re. Okay, re bun is sentence. So if you see this bun part, this kanji is common across here. So bun ke. Okay, it's a sentence pattern. This is re bun. So same kanji. Moving on. Anata wa Mike Meera san desu ka? It's a question. Correct? Are you Mike Meera san? Correct? Am I correct? So anatawa is being put in bracket because we'll also learn that it's not being generally used. You is not just. So to give a respect to the person, Mike Meera san desu ka? It's a question that we are asking another person to confirm whether the other person is Mike Meera or not. So what does Mike Meera says? Hi, watashi wa Mike Meera desu. Again, watashiwa, you can be used or it can be silent also. It depends on the context and the environment you are. Better to use hi, watashiwa, Mike Meera desu. Watashiwa, so and so this. Second example is Meera san wa gakusei desu ka? Is Meera san a student? Answer is iie, watashiwa gakusei deva arimasen. Okay, kaisha in this. Iie watashi wa gakusei deva arimasen. Kaisha in this. Iie. What is he doing? He's saying no, I am not a student. I am actually a company employee. Okay. Here, what did he ask? Meera-san, is a student? No, I'm not a student. I'm a kaisha in. Okay, I'm a company employee. Then question is one san wa engineer desu ka? One san wa engineer desu ka? Is one san an engineer? Iie, one san wa engineer deva arimasen, isha desu. Okay, so one san wa engineer desu ka? Iie, one san wa engineer deva arimasen, isha desu. Understood up to this point? Okay. More of examples. Anu kata wa donata desu ka? Who is this person? Or it's another way is like, please can you introduce me to this person? Okay. So the answer is Watto-san desu. Sakura Daigakusei no sensei desu. So he's Watto-san and is a teacher or a professor in Sakura Daigaku. Okay. Now Teresa chan wa nansai desu ka? Again, what is he doing here? It's Teresa chan. It's Teresa, probably a boy or girl, child. How much is the age of that child?
तो थेरेसा चैनवा नन साइडस का क्यू साइडस, ओके क्यू साइडस, दिस ऑल्सो वी हैव लर्न्ड हाउ टू प्रोनाउंस इट क्यू, नाइन इज वॉट क्यू, लर्न्ड इट इन न्यूमेरिकल्स राइट, क्यू साइडस, ओके. Then comes conversation, okay, Kaiwa. So in Kaiwa, what happens generally is when we used to learn in a physical classrooms, so there will be different people who would play the roles, and so if the same so in this conversation there are three people, say one would become Sato-san and another would become Yamada and then third person will become Mira. So there are some sentence patterns which each of one will say and it will become a conversation. So this way you the student would use to you know get more accustomed or more they got an opportunity to speak or to pronounce the language, and that was an improvement point. So please try to follow the same practice at your end. Maybe what we can do is we can make some groups and then a live session of 3-4 people we can arrange for. Okay. Sato. So first is red marked is Sato-san. Okay. He's saying Ohayou gozaimasu. Okay. So what? Good morning. What does Yamada say? Ohayou gozaimasu. Sato-san. Kochira wa Mike Mira-san desu. So he's introducing, Yamada-san is introducing Mike Mira-san. Okay. Ohayou gozaimasu. Sato-san. Kochira wa Mike Mira-san. Kochira wa is what? Here. In the same room, there's another person. So that's why he's saying Kochirawa. This that person or this person is Mike Mira-san. Then Mike Mira is saying Hajimemashite because he is meeting for the first time. Okay, this the theme of this conversation is Hajimemashite. It's meeting for the first time. So Yamada-san and Sato-san they knew each other. Then Hajimemashite is who is saying because Mike Mira is coming for the first time. That's why he's saying Hajimemashite. He is meeting Sato-san for the first time. Mike Mira. This. So he introduced himself as Mike Mira this. Okay. Then America kara kimashita. So he came from America. That's what he is talking about. Then dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So now this piece, okay, this piece of information, this black is very important because whenever now you have to start introducing yourself in Japanese, these are the four sentences which you must learn and learn to speak. And there will be more of such sentences because you will tell more about yourself. But at first, you need to start saying or speaking these four lines at least. Okay, hajimemashite, bow a little. Okay, at this point of time, hajimemashite, Mike Mira desu, or your name desu, America, Indo kara kimashita. Dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So these are four basic sentences that you have to speak when you are introducing yourselves. Please keep that in your mind. Then Sato-san says, hi, Keiko desu. Dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So this Sato-san says, Sato Keiko desu. So what he has done is, he has introduced his full name. Saito, his full name is this. Okay. Dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So he also says, Dozo yoroshiku. So from now onwards, there will be an exchange of favor and request. So that's why they say, Dozo yoroshiku onegai shimasu. And it's a very commonly used word. Negashimas is something, please do this favor for me. Okay, so this brings us to an end of lecture one, and I'll probably come up with some assignments for you where you can start putting in your question answer mechanism and an automated way of checking your answers whether it's correct or not. Probably some recorded sessions also, so that I haven't fully thought of till now. But let me think through it and let me come up with that approach. And basically, if you have not still subscribed to the channel, please do so. Please share it with your friends so that they know there is a lecture like this available on YouTube, and it's so that we keep on learning from here. And and of course, your feedback definitely is very important. Please subscribe and like this channel. Thank you. Bye bye. はい、終わりましょう。